Hi everybody, I am Thekla Petridou and this is our weekly video blog, aka vlog in English. I sincerely do apologize for not posting a video in English last Friday because of the fuss that was going around due to the current coronavirus pandemic. I was so much absorbed in producing daily videos in Greek for people who stay at home at this time, that it totally slipped my mind to make the video in English. But thankfully, one of you has sent me today, this morning, an email in English, which is very suitable for our weekly vlog. Living with someone with depression. Hi, Mrs. Petridou. Hope you are well and safe during this pandemic situation. I am well for the time being, and I try to be safe for the time being, as everybody should, staying at home and following the guidelines for social distancing and taking precautions not to spread the coronavirus pandemic. I'm writing to you in English, as I am uncomfortable writing in Greek. Apologies for any inconvenience. No, your email has been a relief for me because you reminded me that I should make a video in English, and you give me the words, or you give me the title and the subject to talk about in English today. To give you some backstory, I'm a half Cypriot, 23-year-old student studying abroad, and I have been diagnosed with chronic depression. I have a history of suicidal tendencies and thoughts. I was diagnosed only a couple years ago and have been doing psychotherapy the last year along with medication. Good for you. This depression dates back to my early teenage years, even though I was just an ordinary teenager. I always knew something was, in brackets, wrong with me, as I always suppressed my emotions and wore a mask with everyone, including my family. All these sound as typical chronic depression features or symptoms. It was my girlfriend, who I have currently been with for 10 years, who noticed my behavior is not normal and suggested I speak to a psychologist or a psychiatrist. I owe a lot to my girlfriend. She has saved my life on several occasions and excused my sometimes unusual behavior and stuck to my side through everything. She has watched your TV show and suggested for me to go to a psychiatrist that was on your show, who I currently do my therapy with. You are in very good hands. You are in very safe hands. We now watch your YouTube channel, to which I have to congratulate you, for the main reason being that you woke up people with a stubborn, typical Greek and Cypriot mentality of addressing mental health issues. I thought it would be an interesting topic to hear your thoughts on. What's it like living with someone with depression, no matter what relationship you have with this person, and how people can help them? Not everyone is as lucky as I was to have someone to notice my behavior was not just me being dramatic or just going through a phase. I feel as though many people don't know how to react and just label those people as pelos. Pelos means crazy in the Cypriot lingo. Especially in Greece and Cyprus, where depression hasn't yet been socially accepted. You are so right. Cyprus and Greece, Cypriot and Greek society, have a lot of way to go in order to accept people with depression in a normal way, to accept that depression can be part of a person's life, or can be part of society, can be part of anybody's life, even their own life, not only other people's lives. I've seen many cases where people with symptoms of depression struggle socially, and people rarely consider their side of the story. Or in other cases, people in regular contact with people with mental health symptoms diminish their feelings and ignore their silent cries for help. This could equally apply for people with anxiety. Thank you for your time. Again, it would be very interesting to hear what you have to say. Potentially, this could be a vlog topic where I would say, feel free to answer Greek, which I would prefer, as this issue is common between Greeks and Cypriots. Best wishes. Even though you prefer for me to answer to you in Greek, I answer to you in English so that we have our weekly vlog in English this week. My friend, you are half Cypriot, and it seems that you might have inherited from your Cypriot side a gene for depression. When depression and symptoms of depression appear so early as in teenage years, genetic factor plays a huge role in a person's depression, depressive disorder or emotional disorder. That's why you got the diagnosis chronic depression, which means that it goes around with you, it follows you, and it could last on your life. The good news about you is that you had somebody in your life, like your girlfriend, to notice that maybe your acting out was not just acting out as a typical teenager, but was maybe it was a symptom or a sign of depression, and urged you and gave you the necessary push or the idea, or was with you by your side to go through treatment, to find a psychologist or a psychotherapist or a psychiatrist in your case that suits you, that you can communicate with, that has good knowledge of his or her science, and help you with the two ways that are equally necessary in order to treat depression. The first way is antidepressant medication, which only psychiatrists can prescribe on somebody who has depression, and the second way is psychotherapy. Psychotherapy can be performed either by a psychologist or a psychotherapist or a psychiatrist who is also a psychotherapist. So bear in mind that you might find yourself in the position to take antidepressant medication for many years or for all your life. That's not a bad thing, that's a beautiful thing, because this beautiful medicine has been invented by science, and we have a way to regulate our brain hormones, our endorphins, and we found a way through modern antidepressant medication, SSRIs, selective serotonin SSRIs. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. That's what SSRI means. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. This medication goes to your bloodstream and goes into your nerves, and it doesn't allow them to flush serotonin through the out of the body. So this, when you take this medication, your serotonin levels rise. And because we haven't found yet a way to produce serotonin in a laboratory, or another way to induce our brain to produce more serotonin when we need it, these medications, SSRIs, are helpful, because gradually, when you take these pills, in about 3-4 weeks, your serotonin levels go back to normal, and all the symptoms of depression slowly go away. And if you keep taking them, then you are your true self, yourself without depression. That's why I'm saying that it's a blessing for people with chronic depression, the invention of SSRIs, because they are found to be a permanent solution along with psychotherapy for people with chronic depression. Some people will take SSRIs for 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, and then stop. We never start SSRIs or antidepressants or any other psychiatric medication without the permission and the guidance of a psychiatrist. and we never stop them without the permission and the guidance by a psychiatrist. Some people who have short depression, they might need to take medication for a short time. Some other people might need to take for a longer period of time, but it's nothing really to be ashamed of, because this medication has nothing to do with antipsychotic medication, which people are afraid of, medication that alters yourself, that makes you moody or makes you sleepy or makes you like lazy or makes you feel like shut down or look like shut down. On the contrary, antidepressants are medication, modern antidepressants, SSRIs, are medication that helps you be your real self and helps you be in shape daily. It rises your energy levels, because one major symptom of depression is that you feel very tired and you have no stamina to go through daily life. That's why suicidal thoughts are part of chronic depression symptoms. You ask a very specific question. How can we help a person in our life who we understand or we think that they might have depression? And then how do we help somebody who know that is diagnosed with depression? If someone is in our environment, either a family member or a romantic partner or a friend or a co-worker, shows signs of mental distress, shows symptoms that look like as if he or she's not well, they are moody, they have very pessimistic views, they do not like to go out often or as before, they express discomfort, you can see in their face that they are not feeling well and they are not happy, you could suggest that it would be a good idea to visit a psychologist. And you could say that in a polite manner, not in a manner that you are crazy, you should go and see a shrink. No. I care about you. I love you. I've seen the last couple of months or the last couple of weeks that you are not being your real self. Would you like to talk to me? What's going on with you? And you can tell a story. If you have a personal story, for example, I have a personal story. I can tell my personal story that back in my 20s, when I had depression, I was not diagnosed, and this made my life so horrible. And I spent a lot of time in battling with this enemy that depression is. I spent a lot of energy, a lot of money, a lot of valuable time battling with this beast. And when I accepted the fact at the age of 35 or 36 that I have chronic depression as well, and I pushed myself to visit a psychiatrist and take antidepressant medication, my life changed, and I realized that for 15 or so years I was being a fool, that I was wasting my time, my money, my energy for battling with depression, that I could never be on top of depression unless I had the help of antidepressant medication. I have a personal story to say. Somebody else might not have a personal story, but they might have some other people's stories, or these people's the stories we read here on our videos, on our vlogs. You can say, or you can send send a video to somebody and say, check out this video. I watch this channel and this psychologist is talking about various matters, relationships, love relationships, and she also talks about depression, anxiety. I thought it might interest you. I mean, you could say in a subtle manner that, I don't know, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a psychologist, I cannot diagnose, but if were I in your position, I would love it to have somebody to suggest to me to go to see a therapist. So we do not point out in a bad manner to make the other person feel bad, like we that we make fun of them or we diminish them because of their behavior or because of their symptoms, but we encourage them to ask for professional help. And I'm saying again that at least in Cyprus, that I've worked for so many years, for 20 years, I have worked as a psychologist in Cyprus. I had a private practice. I've seen thousands of people come to my office, and I strongly believe that half Cypriots, at least, are born with a tendency for depression and anxiety. Some of us, we are born with stronger genes, and depression and anxiety starts from teenage years. Some other are more lucky than us, and they have these symptoms in an older age, at the age of 30 or 35 or 40, and they might have a shorter period of treatment. Anyway, if somebody has chronic depression, we should have chronic therapy. How you deal with the situation when you live with somebody or you are in a relationship with somebody who is diagnosed with depression and is currently taking therapy and taking medication? We should be no different than in any other case. If somebody is currently under psychotherapy and taking medication, we should not be judgmental of them going to therapy. We should not be criticizing their choice to take antidepressants, because there are a lot of know-it-alls around that say, oh, you take chemistry, you put chemistry in your body, you put chemistry in your brain, you shouldn't take antidepressant medications, you should try herbs, or you should try something else. All of this thing is BS. I've tried all of it, acupuncture, homeopathic medicine in the past, from my 20s to my 30s. Name it, I tried it. I spent a fortune in buying overpriced bottles with water or placebo effect, I don't know what. They say, drink this or take this and you will get relieved. Nothing helped. What really helped me was taking the SSRIs, okay? Suggest to anybody to stop psychotherapy. We shouldn't suggest to anybody to stop taking their medication. We shouldn't misjudge them for this. A person who is on therapy and on some medication, this doesn't mean that they are crazy. This doesn't mean that they cannot take care of themselves. It doesn't mean they are somebody to feel sorry for. It's a human being that you chose freely to have a relationship with this person and respect this person. And people with depression, we should learn to ask for help. We should learn to express our feelings. We go to our partner, we go to our family member, we go to our friends, say, today I'm having a bad day. Because even when you take medication, antidepressive medication, especially women, in some days of the month, their medication might not be working so well because of the hormonal imbalance of menstrual cycle. So you might say, today I feel angry. I feel a lot of anger building inside. Today I feel anxious. Today I feel depressed. I feel sad. Please be encouraging with me. Please bear me. And of course, me that I have depression, or you that you have depression, you also have to bear through your partner where they're going through a rough patch. Okay? I don't think that people with depression need special treatment. On the contrary, they need to be treated as equal human beings. Having sensitivity, having empathy to your partners or to your friends or to your family members' situation is something that we should have about everybody, not only about people who go through mental struggles. We should be empathetic towards our parents, empathetic towards our children, empathetic towards our partner, empathetic towards our friend. We should be friendly with our friends. We should be loving with your loved ones. You don't need special treatment when you have depression, because the people who discharge someone with going through a mental disorder, these are the same people that they would behave badly and in a toxic way to somebody in their lives that they are healthy, isn't it? So thank you very much, my friend, for your email. I hope you found this topic interesting, and I would love to read your opinion on the comments. If you like this video, please rate and subscribe on my channel, and push the bell button so that every time I upload a video, you have a notification. Bear in mind that most of my videos are in Greek language. Only every Friday, 1 p.m., I release a video in English. Have a nice weekend, everybody. And stay home and stay safe and stay sane. Bye.